Hall of Fame member Judy Rankin. Let's take a look at some highlights from what we've already seen today. And we start with Trish Johnson here.
Sometimes get the ball close.
And we'll go to the ninth and bring in Paige McKenzie.
This is Charlotta Sorenstam, her first time playing in this event as she recently met the age requirement.
She's going with one club more. 7-iron, drawing it against that left to right slope.
Let's see if that'll have a bit more momentum to bring it down towards the flag.
Yeah, ends up a very good shot.
Yeah, this has been a difficult test, Kay. I mean, keeping the bogeys off the card has not been easy. And that was a great chance for her first birdie of the day, going missing that.
You know, you could say this about any number of players in the field, but Nicole Jeray is one of those players.
Back at the ninth, this is Helen Alfredson. Oh, yeah. Helen Alfredson. See if she can clean it up. And a good birdie, too. One of the very few holes that are playing under par today. Gives the players a good opportunity.
Mora always impressed me with her golf game when she was playing regularly on the LPGA Tour. But she just didn't cash in often enough and get those chances to win. But she always had a very good-looking golf game, and clearly it has stuck with her.
A couple of bunkers out in the fairway, one on the right that really doesn't come into play. The left one will if you draw it. Interestingly, this hole played the hardest hole on the course yesterday. And maybe for that reason, hard to clear that bunker, hard to get up to the plateau because it plays uphill. Junior, amateur, college golf, but when you're a retired pro, probably not spending as much time. See if she can keep this just below the hole. Well, that's going to leave her a bending right to left putt. And she just has to be careful not to be too frisky with it, or she'll have a long comebacker for bogey.
And we always see what happens inside the ropes, but the USGA working tirelessly on many projects outside of the ropes as well. Great to see. This is at the 10th. Lita Lindley with a lovely approach there.
Yeah, beautiful shot. Fairway metal.
Now Lita Lindley after that lovely approach at the 10th. This for a birdie. Yeah, well done. And she's got it going today. No drop shots. 3 under par. Anyone associated with the LPGA Tour and women's golf will know that this is a great city for watching golf.
I played here the first time in 1972.
Pitch shot right back up the hill. There it is.
Up and over the pine trees. But she has the altitude to do it, trying to cut it a little. Well, that was really nice from having to deal with those tall trees as an obstacle. Beat her age with her score. Shot 80. She's 84. Amazing. Similar putt to what Nicole had.
Little cut up with her, and I did not realize who it was.
Well, out of context, maybe.
Great shot.
We're used to seeing Beth with the clubs, not necessarily carrying them, but that a great leave. And she's been close. Multiple times. Very nice.
Talked about how much farther the ball is flying and going in the afternoon versus the morning playing this golf course. The air heats up, it becomes warm, the course dries out. First four greens in regulation today, but has kind of figured something out and has hit the last four.
Opportunity right there.
He just very well may. This should have a little left to right. No, she was playing it right to left. That was a kind of a head scratcher. Obviously, I don't think I read that right.
Well, it didn't move much. It actually stayed relatively straight, which may explain why there's some confusion, but easy par of how it would move opposite that.
Well, that was Katrina's. That was her 13th birdie.
And the danger is, of course, if you are long, it is one of the fastest putts you'll see on this golf course.
Come back down.
Oof. One's got to be careful.
Easy.
What did you say about this hole when you were working the U.S. Women's?
Apparently, when I worked here in 2000.
See if she can limit the damage. You said it, Junie. One bad shot off the tee, and all of a sudden, it's a couple drop shots.
Yeah, recovery is just so difficult.
And on the 11th tee, this is Annika. Looks like an aggressive line towards the hole. Oh, yeah. Well done.
Beautiful.
Just missed her birdie.
Well, I liked it when she struck it. I did. I thought it was going to take a U-turn.
9 wins in her LPGA career, including a major. She won the 1997 KPMG Women's PGA, which was then the LPGA Championship, and that one drops.
She looks exactly the way she looked 20 years ago.
Here's Annika at the 12th. Second shot. Here's Annika's birdie putt at the 12th.
One of the flatter greens on the golf course.
USGA champion Kay Cockrell is out there on the golf course, and Ryan Pratt from the USGA to answer any rules questions. Let's go to the 11th.
Katrina trying to find the middle of the green with that 9-iron, but pulled it. It went that extra distance, and that's not going to be a good leave.
No, it's just going to get a little bit of help back, but the ball will settle up there, and that is fast. Get it on the correct line, as much break as there is.
She played about 5 feet of break and hit that putt as if it were a 4-footer. How about that for a lag? Classy.
Good judgment. And this on the 13th, Lita Lindley has also got a nice round going. Started the day 2 over, so she'll have another look at birdie. Well, it has been a clean card for Lita Lindley, who has now made 4 birdies on her day.
And Lita Lindley is another one of those square greens, Judy, that you've had your eye on this
week.
Yeah,
I think they're just very interesting.
And
good
another,
shot.
Yeah, another birdie chance coming up for Lita Lindley. What a day it's been so far. And Lita Lindley is another one of those square greens, Judy, that you've had your eye on this
week.
Yeah,
I think they're just very interesting.
Another,
shot.
Yeah, another birdie chance coming up for Lita Lindley. What a day it's been so far.
Her husband, Matt, is on the bag.
Peculiar.
Good.
Got a really good solid strike on that one.
And she is another one right behind Trish Johnson, who is a lover of Lynx golf. She lives on the famed.
Now, Catriona Matthew with her second at 12.
After a big climb up Bunker Hill to this fairway, a level second, that an 8-iron.
Yeah, there are a few climbs on this golf course.
There are rewards, even when it's a tough go.
Yeah, a lot of balmier in San Francisco in the winter.
Our winters are are warmer than our summers.
I was going to say San Francisco in the summer, but yes.
You go get us a place, Kay, in North Berwick, and I'll come visit you and Danny often.
Just a few paces ahead of where Catriona hit from. Missed her first four greens in regulation today, but has hit every green since. Really did a good job of getting up and down initially, and then has just found her rhythm as the round has progressed.
Nazareth Academy in LaGrange, Illinois, coaches a girls team, and went to high school there and played on the boys team.
That was right in the heart.
She's been looking all day for that. That's her first birdie.
Good putt.
Annika, on the other hand, we've seen quite a few times over the last several years, including at Pebble Beach in the U.S. Women's Open. And that one dragged away to the left. Annika at the 14th, the par 3 out of the bunker here. Oh, whoa, whoa. And Annika, we saw her have trouble coming out of the bunker. This is for bogey.
That the women's golf is getting some of the attention that it has deserved for quite a long time.
We saw Trish Johnson hole out for bunker on the 6th earlier. Not quite as good, but a well-executed bunker shot. We saw Trish Johnson's bunker shot to this point.
Oof. Boy, and you could see her just come up and out of that, you know, eighth of a second too quick.
Here is the co-chair, and Peter is the honorary chair of the U.S. Senior Women's Open here this week at Waverley.
Go.
Asking for all that she could get out of that 8-iron.
She got it.
She got it.
Four paces ahead from where Nicole hit this, a 9-iron. And she's pulled that. Yeah, Judy, we talked about that. Her miss has been left either too much of a draw or a pull. Overall left to right movement. She's got to get the speed right.
Not bad.
Downhill sliding putt.
If I'd have hit it.
Didn't hit it.
A little conservative.
Day just walking back to our hotel, and there they were in their front yard.
Trish Johnson for a birdie at 14. Golf is part of the fabric of life there.
Yes.
Okay.
All right, well, I said it was an opportunity to get aggressive on this hole. We'll see if Annika can take advantage.
A little tiny bit awkward putting from the sun to the shade. You don't see it quite as clearly.
Look like a good roll. She'll have the long par 3, 16 next, and then a pair of par 5s coming in where she has the length to likely get to both of them. So a couple opportunities upcoming.
Oh, a done balls. 16. Yeah, the fist pump. 94% of the field hitting the green now. Nicole Jeray for birdie.
Downhill putt, not a lot of movement. Just kind of trailed off to the right.
Day, that mistake at the 11th, missing the green and then not being able to keep the ball on the green with the bunker shot. And Nicole Jeray just letting a shot go there. That was a shame.
She knew she fanned it a little bit to start, didn't quite have enough.
Haunted her the last two, maybe 3 years.
Trish Johnson, birdie putt on the way. Oh, and in. Well done.
Out at the 16th, Tammy Green. For a birdie. Is that going to go? Oh, it does. And Tammy Green with back-to-back birdies, 15 and 16. Trish Johnson on the tee. Heading left down towards the tee and maybe the penalty area there. That is close. This is the 16th. It looks like Trish is just far enough away from the wood there not to have an issue and may get away with a par. Yeah, good three in the end. It looked like she could be in big trouble with that tee shot. She walks away with a par.
Annika has a third shot approach on this par five. It drove it into the fairway bunker, so had to lay up to here. Little feed in there nicely.
Beautiful shot.
And now this is the birdie putt for Annika. Just came right off the face.
Yeah.
If she goes on the light of the flag, that she can carry the front bunker.
Had a couple of shots slip over the last few holes. Needs a good one here.
Yeah, that came in a little lower and left side of the green. It's really hard to tell where these balls end up, Tom.
She's going to be very happy when she gets up there. It's one of the best we've seen, Kay.
Well, that's a nice bonus for her.
Has not changed over so many years, and the right-hand bunker also. It's a feature that's been here pretty much as long as he can remember.
Need much more. That's going to be a five for Lita Lindley. This is Nicole Jeray for the birdie.
Oh, what a good fight back. We know she has fight in her, Tom. She showed it her whole career.
That's an impressive golf swing.
Now Trish Johnson, a little higher lofted club coming in here. Get over that front portion of the green.
What excitement there was both at Cherry Hills and at Bel Air. Out to 17.
This for eagle. An outright lead. We've seen a couple of players of her, which is this group, Trish Johnson, now for birdie.
Yeah.
And that will take her to four under and currently tied for the lead.
Oh, this going way too far to the right. There is a penalty area over there that comes in just off the edge of the fairway. She's hit a lot of these shots at North Berwick. And her goal right now is to get this up and in for a par and not lose any shots on this hole. Roughly 15 paces to the front, another 22 to the hole. Oh, and she got a little too much bite on that, didn't carry it. Needed to carry it probably another five paces, so. Looked like a pretty good stroke.
Yeah, that was a superb effort. But when you evaluate the round, if you say I made six on a par five that I could reach into quite easily.
Just a moment ago, Annika for a birdie at the 18th. It's going to be a round of 72 for Annika. 18th hole. Changes the angle a little bit with this up tee.
She loves that.
So great.
Nice shot. For miles, but just, yeah, stays in the fairway.
Oh my. That is way out there.
Trish Johnson going for the green in two.
The ball maybe is just ever so slightly below your feet as you play to the 18th green.
Now Trish Johnson, this is her third at the par five. So I'm going to get over the ridge. This for a birdie. It's just going to be a par. She'd be disappointed to walk away with a five here.
Well, I don't think she hit that poor a shot into the green, but, you know, it's one of those that had it gone 3 feet to the right instead of 3 feet to the left, she would have been putting for eagle.
It'll be a big day tomorrow. That's the low round of the championship so far. Wonderful effort, 67 today. And one off the low...
Asian arts of so on and so forth, they help to quiet your mind under pressure.
Oh, Catriona went after that three wood, but she pulled it with a draw.
Oh, careful, there's some nasty little humps and bumps in that bunker, and that looks like it's on a downslope there.
And hoping to dial in the right distance. Caught it cleanly. That was
lovely.
Really nice. Really nice. Because that was an awkward angle. Oh, caught too much ball. Came out hot.
But he got a little bit of stop.
Yeah,
I
it
think
wasn't
when she
bad.
Caught all that, yeah, she caught all that ball and she spun it in a way. It's
That's
actually a great
amazing.
Shot.
All right, see if she can read this. This would be one heck of a birdie.
I don't think she hit it.
She sure didn't. Forever with diabetes, and golf is stressful enough, much less compounding it with an ailment.
And this to finish off with another birdie. But you've got to hand it to Nicole Jeray, hanging in there, struggled early. A couple of birdies late in the round, and she is just... She will play with Trish Johnson in that final pairing tomorrow.